The Green Party has unveiled its first big policy announcement of election season: tax. Specifically, more of it, from the top to the bottom. A new guaranteed minimum income could see individuals who are out of work or studying pocket $385 a week after tax. Couples will get $770, and a single parent entitled to at least $735 a week. The plan would be phased in over 2 years, and to pay for it, the Greens would bring in a wealth tax, 2.5% on assets worth more than $4 million for couples or $2 million for individuals. The party would also implement a new top tax rate of 45% on incomes of more than $180,000. And the corporate tax rate would lift as well to 33%. That's the stick. Here's the carrot. For anyone earning under $125,000, there'd be a tax-free threshold of $10,000. The Greens are hoping this will win them back some ailing support. To hear why, we're joined now by party co-leader James Shaw. Mr. Shaw, how did you decide that asking people to pay more money would get you more votes?
Well, as you said, actually 95%, 3.7 million New Zealanders will actually pay less tax under this proposal. And the wealth tax that you mentioned only applies to 0.7% of the country. And so what we're saying is we actually have an opportunity to end child poverty in this country once and for all. And that should be the mark of a civilised society. And we think a more progressive tax system in which the majority of people get a bit of a break to help them through tough times, whilst asking those who have most amongst us to be able to contribute a wee bit more.
I'm not saying it's not a good ambition to have, but is there any country in the world that has seriously been able to eradicate child poverty?
Well, we are the only country in the OECD, the only country that does not have a wealth tax, a capital gains tax, a stamp duty, inheritance taxes, or some combination of all of those things. We have done a good job over the course of the last 6 years of this government in lifting about 30,000 children above the material hardship line. There's about another 45,000 children who are still below that material hardship line. And what we're saying is, why not everyone? The cost of this package is about $10 billion a year, and that's about half what we spend on superannuation. So we think it's ambitious, but it is realistic within the next parliament.
The polling figures show, though, your support is lagging, and it's the right that is picking up voters. So what is it about this policy that you think is going to win over the support that you need? You tell us, most times we have you on, that Green Party needs more people in government to get what you want pushed through. How are you going to get those voters back?
Well, I mean, our polling on average is actually higher now than it was on election night 2020. But the point here is that we're laying out a positive vision for the country where we actually bring everybody with us and we leave no one behind. And in this election, we think that if people want to live in a society where we do look after each other and that those who need our support the most receive that support when they need that support, then we're putting something on the table and saying, look, this should be the mark of a civilised society, and it should be a measure of any political party, that they do have a plan to eliminate poverty in Aotearoa.
But this sort of approach is preaching to the converted, is it not?
Well, what we're saying is here is a solution to one of the greatest challenges of our time. And, you know, why wouldn't you do that during an election campaign to say, look, you know, on the one hand, you've got a very bleak vision of the future. You've got parties who are attacking the use of te reo on road signs alongside English and you know, whose sole vision for the future of the country is a ministry of deregulation, fewer rules to keep us safe and to protect the environment. On the other, we're saying, actually, we have the opportunity here to lift every child who's currently below the material hardship line above that line.
How are you going to sell it to Labor then?
Well, my job isn't to sell it to the Labor Party. My job is to work with New Zealanders who want to live in a country where we look after each other. You know, this isn't about how we position ourselves relative to other political parties. This is saying this is one of the greatest challenges of our time. It is the single greatest policy failure of the last 3 or 4 decades that we have allowed this level of inequality and poverty to creep into our society. And we have a realistic and ambitious plan to fix that.
it is also a realistic option that the Labor Party will turn around and say, you can be in government with us, but we're not doing that. What are you going to do about the chance that that might happen? It's happened before with some policies.
Well, I think if people want to vote for the solution to poverty, we are putting one on the table. And, you know, if you don't like my plan, go and talk to the other parties about what their plans are to completely eliminate poverty here. Like I said, this isn't about other political parties. I think that the voters will have their say in October, and they can determine the shape of the next government and the level of influence that the Green Party has within that government in order to be able to execute this plan.
There's one more topic I wanted to quickly throw a question at you about, because we only got a short response from Marama yesterday on the news, and it maybe seemed a little flippant, but in regards to National's plans for genetic engineering, do you believe that the industry needs more or less regulation? Is it time for that to be reviewed?
Well, it is actually being reviewed by the government right now, and we're comfortable with the review. We obviously don't have a view on where that is going to land. That's the job of the review itself. This isn't anything new from the National Party. I mean, they've been saying this for at least 10 years.
All right. Minister James Shaw, thank you very much for your time this morning.
Thank you.